I have been covering the U.S.-backed anti-government and also anti-monarchy movement here in Thailand for many, many years. And this most recent round of political destabilization, which has lasted well over a year, has culminated in a few events in the last couple of weeks. There was a court ruling that ruled that these U.S.-backed agitators are actually pursuing sedition, not reform. That was a major deal. There was also the protests themselves, which are struggling to just get a couple of hundred people out in the streets. In Bangkok, a city of over 10 million people, this is all they can get out into the streets. And yet they'll continuously be depicted by the Western media as pro-democracy, which you would generally associate with representing the majority. And this isn't even a sizable minority. This is a small, tiny handful of people who could, on certain days of their protest, be mistaken for people just waiting for the bus at a bus stop. Now, there has been another development just today. This is Joint Sitting Dumps Charter Amendment Bill sponsored by civic groups. And this whole article is completely misleading. What happened was the opposition parties backed by the U.S. and a U.S. government-funded NGO petitioned the government to basically rewrite the constitution or amend certain parts of Thailand's constitution, the highest law in the land. And the parliament completely shot it down, didn't even come close to passing. Let's read through the article. I'm going to tell you what went wrong with this article. And I'm not just picking on this newspaper. All of the Western media and their collaborators here in Thailand, they have all reported it just as inaccurately. So let's go through it real quick. A joint sitting of parliament rejected a charter amendment bill providing a people's constitution at its first reading on Wednesday. So this concept of a people's constitution being pushed by an unpopular mob that cannot even get 1,000 people into the streets on a Sunday evening when no one is at work. They cannot even get 1,000 people in the streets, and they're going to claim that this constitution is the people's constitution. And by the way, they will tell you who sponsored this, who was pushing this petition, but they won't tell you who was funding them. So let's go back to the article. So then they're just giving you the basic breakdown of who voted for what. The vast majority voted against it. And so it says here, the bill had the support of more than 135,000 eligible voters and called for key changes in the 2017 constitution. 135,000 signatures out of almost 70 million people as the population of Thailand. So you do the math and you tell me if that's representative of the majority or even a sizable minority in the country. I'm thinking not. It was sponsored by Internet Law Reform Dialogue, ReSolution Group, the Progressive Movement, and the Move Forward Party. And they tell you absolutely nothing about who they are or who's behind them. But I will. So first they mention Internet Law Reform Dialogue, and as you can see, I'm on the U.S. government's National Endowment for Democracy website. This is the funding arm for political subversion and interference of the U.S. government, interfering in nations all around the globe. And this Internet Law Reform Dialogue is listed right here by name alongside the money amount in US dollars that it receives from the US government every single year. And then if you go to their website, this is iLaw. That's what it's called for short. And if you come down, they've got it in Thai and also in English. At least they're disclosing it to the public. Internet Law Reform Dialogue, iLaw. Who is funding it? The National Endowment for Democracy, as well as George Soros' Open Society Foundation, and also Henrik Boll, which is just the German version of the National Endowment for Democracy. It's all absolutely 100% political interference inside of Thailand's internal political affairs, in violation of the UN Charter, and in this case, attempting to rewrite the Thai Constitution. Bangkok Post also says the ReSolution Group, Progressive Movement, and Move Forward Party. And if you go to the ReSolutionCon.com, so basically this is all about rewriting the entire Constitution. This was put together by ILO. This is all their graphics. This is their graphic team doing this. And if you go all the way down to the bottom, there's Resolution, there's Progressive Movement, there's Move Forward. So these are the two opposition parties, both run by Thanathan Jhuvangrungrungkid. He is this US-backed billionaire. He literally went to the United States before the 2019 general election to go find support in the United States in his bid to run for office in Thailand. So and now he's partnered with a U.S. government-funded front trying to rewrite Thailand's constitution. I have the Foreign Agent Registration Act document, which Thanathan's lobbyists were required to file under U.S. law, and it details his itinerary while he was in the United States. Foreign Agents Registration Act. This is filed by APCO Worldwide. That's the lobbying group Thanathan used during his trip to the United States. And if you come down here he is, Thanathan Jhuvangrungrungkid. This is all of the activity he was scheduled for while in the United States. And who was he talking to? He's talking to the U.S. House Foreign Affairs Committee. He's talking to USAID. USAID hands money out to people. Thanathan is a billionaire. He and his family are billionaires. Why is he talking to USAID? Because you know why USAID hands money out. It's usually for the US to expand its influence inside of another nation, another sovereign nation. Who else did he talk to? He talked to people from the US State Department. He talked to all of these people in the Western media, and he also talked to representatives from Freedom House. Now, Freedom House is a subsidiary of the National Endowment for Democracy, and the National Endowment for Democracy is the front the U.S. government puts money through to fund organizations like ILAW, which, together with Thanathan and his political parties, just tried to rewrite the Thai Constitution. And then here, ILAW and CONLAB and ELEC, these are all connected to the U.S. government. They're all, ILAW is directly funded by the U.S. government. CONLAB, let me show you something about CONLAB. I'm going to put the link to this article in the video description below. This is my complete guide to U.S. government meddling in Thailand's student protests. I wrote this in August 2020 when I was still using the Tony Cartolucci pen name. And if you come down here to CONLAB, this is CONLAB. This is what they were doing. They're at the American corner, Chiang Mai, talking about rewriting Thailand's constitution. As you can see, it's not a very big crowd because this is the U.S. backing these people to rearrange Thailand's political system so that U.S. interests can prevail within the Thai political system rather than the actual interests of the people living in Thailand. This is political meddling. This is what the U.S. does in every single country. It's what they just tried to do and thankfully were stopped by Parliament. The textbook definition of treason applies. Now, whether that applies to the Thai legal definition of treason or not, that is another story. That is not my business. I'm not Thai. This is for Thai people to look into. This is for the Thai courts to sort out on their own. I'm just showing you that this protest and this opposition movement in Thailand that the Western media claims is pro-democracy and the people's constitution, it's just not true. It is a billionaire and a US-backed NGO that pushed this forward. They scraped together 130,000 signatures, which anyone with any amount of resources could drum up in a couple of months. And that's exactly what they did. So extremely dangerous political interference here in Thailand. Could you imagine China trying to rewrite a part of the U.S. Constitution, how well that would go over, and what the consequences would be for those involved in trying? Just something to keep in mind, the Western media will never tell you this information, this backstory. I will. If you thought this video was useful, please like and share it. Think about subscribing to the channel. It's free to do, and it helps the channel grow. I have a website, newatlas.report. You can find and follow all of my work there. There are no paywalls, there are no ads, and there never will be. So please bookmark it and share it with others. I am also back on Twitter for the time being, @Brian_Berletic. So you can follow me there until Twitter deletes my account again. Also, in the video description, you will find all of the links detailing all of this information that I just shared with you, as well as for ways you can help support my work. And to those who already are, whether it's through Patreon month to month or one-time donations, or even if you're just sending me news tips by email, or you're liking and sharing my work. That helps a lot. I could not do this work without that help. So thank you. And as always, thank you for watching.